Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Asil International Academy, first time in 2021. Today I'm here to explain that the presentation of data, complete theory and definitions with easiest and shortcut method which nobody tells you about. That this lecture contains 9 parts. In part 1 contains data, primary data and secondary data, which is the starting part of the lecture. Part 2 contains graph, diagram or charts, and part 3 contains about the types of graphs. You can say that line graph, histogram, frequency polygon, frequency curve or gen. Part 4 contains about the different types of diagram or charts. Part 5 contains about classification and tabulation. Part 6 contains about discrete and continuous, about next class, you can say that class limits and class boundaries. Next, part 7 contains about the midpoint, cumulative frequency, as you can say that about class interval. And part 8 contains about the parts of table. Next, a last and 9th part contains about the pie diagram, pie chart. You can see that last part is the stem and leaf display. These 9 parts are the gifts for you from mine. So must watch this lecture from starting to end so that you may gain more concise information. Without me wasting any time, let's start the lecture. So part 1 contains, which is the data, primary data and secondary data. Follow these points, very very easy. Data is given here. What is the definition of data? What is data? Very easy. Start. Collection of statistical information. Collection of statistical information is called as data. Must remember that the statistical information collection is called as data. Next step is, what is the difference between primary data and secondary data? Very easy step. Must remember that the data, very easy definition, the data which has not undergone, which has not undergone any statistical treatment is called as primary data. For example, you can write here, for example, I take a short example. For example, you have any problem, you have any question given in the paper. I can write here, question is, find the regression line. Find the regression line. For example, y or x. That's clear? And that question is given here, just like before, you can start it here. X, Y, 1, 2, 3. That's data which is given in your paper. That's data is called as primary data, which has not undergone any statistical treatment. And you can say that fresh data is called as primary data. That's clear? Last step, secondary data. This is the opposite to each other, the data which has undergone any statistical treatment. It's called as secondary data. For example, take a short example about that. For example, You can say that answer of this problem, answer of that problem, you can say that answer of above problem, you can say that after solving that question, that you can say that answer is 13.23. That's called as secondary data. That's not what's number that the given question which has not undergone any statistical is called as primary data. That's clear, very step easy. And secondary data contains which has undergone any statistical treatment. You have solved the question. The answer that's called as secondary data. I hope that you gain a lot of points from that. Now part 2 lecture is coming now, which contains about graph, diagram or charts. Graph is a visual representation of collection of very easy definition, collection of numerical data or statistical data. For example, statistical data. For example, you can write here, for example, I take a very easy example. I have a graph that contains x-axis and that contains y-axis. Now I'm telling you the most important point, which nobody tells you about that. That condition horizontal always contains x, because x is a independent variable, must remember. Independent variable. So it comes on always horizontal section. And y contains is a dependent variable. Dependent variable. So it always comes in vertical direction, must be bonded that. I take an example, this position is 0, you can write here 3, 7, 9, 11, etc. For example, I can take here 5, 15, write here, you can say that 20, 25, approximate, up to so on. I can have, combining the points, you can write here. There's points and combining the 2 points there. For example, I have 2 points this and this. Combining the section here that dash is called as graph. So let's remember that graph is a visual representation of collection of numerical data or statistical data. That's called as graph. Next last point is here, diagram or chart. What is that? Must remember that diagram or chart is similar definition. Now I'm going to discuss a diagram is a symbolic representation. Diagram is a symbolic representation of information using visualization techniques. For example, I take a short example about that. I make a diagram, just example that's the x-axis and that's the y-axis. I take an example here, diagram this and this and this. That's the symbolic representation of information using visualization techniques. That's called as diagram or chart. So that's the difference between graph and diagram or chart. I hope that you have a lot of benefits from this lecture. Now, part two is completed now. Part three is coming now, which contains of types of graphs, line graph, histogram, frequency polygon, frequency curve, and last object. Must also watch that. Line graph is just like of that. For example, you can write here that's the x-axis and that's the y-axis. I write, for example, take here 2, 4, 8, 10, and let's suppose here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's the, I must remember that dash point and dash point combining, you can write here dash. We draw a line this and we combining dash point with dash point right here. That's called as line graph. Must remember that. That's called as line graph. Line graph is always when we meet dash point to dash point, dash shape, dash graph is called as line graph. Must remember. Next point is here histogram. What is histogram? Must remember that. Histogram is just like you can write here. This is our observations, and this is our frequency. Histogram. Moving to the next point. Histogram. Graph of very very easy definition. Writing about the histogram, which nobody tells you about that. Graph of adjacent rectangles. In which class boundaries are taken along x-axis and frequencies. are taken along y-axis is called as histogram. I take an example to understand that point. For example, I make a graph about that. That is the x-axis, that is the x-axis, that is the y-axis. Class boundaries are taken along x-axis. Always frequency taken along y-axis. That graph is called as histogram. Now let it graph of adjacent rectangles. What about that? For example, you can write here rectangles just like about that. That's graph of adjacent rectangle, closest rectangles in which class boundaries are taken along x-axis and frequencies are taken along x-axis. That's called as histogram. Very easy definition. Next step is given here. Frequency polygon. What is frequency polygon? Very simple. Closed shape. Very easy definition about frequency polygon. Closed shape on many sides in which midpoints are taken along x-axis and frequencies along y-axis is called as frequency polygon. How come about that? What is writing a closed shape on set? I take an example. For example, For example, I take an example or take a graph of that's x-axis and y-axis. Given here, midpoints are on x-axis, that's x-axis will be here, midpoints. Midpoints are denoted by small x, as you already know about that, and frequencies is along y-axis. Now writing here, shape of that frequency polygon is just like you can write here. I have a shape just like of that. I move the points so that getting even here. Closed shape, that's the closed shape on many sides, which have many sides in which midpoints are taken along x-axis and frequencies along y-axis, that's called as frequency polygon. I hope that you clear. Next, frequency curve. What is that? Smoothness of frequency polygon is called as frequency curve. For example, I take an example just like that. X-axis, y-axis, and shape of just like writing here. Must remember that dotted lines, there's dotted lines surrounding that section. That's called as frequency curve. You can write here, for example, this star points. So that's, must remember that smoothness of frequency polygon, dotted lines, that's called as frequency curve. Now last point, which is very, very important for you. What is ogive? You can write ogive that is a cumulative frequency polygon. What is that? Graph between upper class boundaries and cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency is called as ogive or cumulative frequency. For example, I take an example of the graph. Upper class boundaries will be on x-axis and on y-axis always will be cumulative frequency. That's graph is called as ogive or cumulative frequency bond. I hope that you gained a lot of points about that. What are the types of graphs, which is definitions. Now, this is the part 3. Now, part 4 is coming now, which is the different types of diagrams or charts. Must also watch now. There are 5 types of diagrams or charts. 5 types of diagrams or charts which are number one is linear or one-dimensional diagram. Linear or one-dimensional diagram. Now, second type is given here, aerial or two-dimensional diagram. Aerial or two-dimensional diagram. Now number third type of diagram is given here, cubic. cubic or three-dimensional diagram. Now, next fourth type is pictograms, and you can say that pie diagram. Pie diagrams and last five is pictograms. Now at part 5, now I'm going to discuss the difference between classification and tabulation. First of all, discuss what is classification. Follow the step, the process, to distribute the given data. Into different classes or groups is called as classification. So must remember that the process to distribute the given data, for example, we have given data just like you can say 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to so just like that. When we convert that data into different classes, you can write here groups, into different classes or groups, that's called as classification. That's here, and next tabulation. Tabulation, what is tabulation? Very simple. The process to arrange the data. The process to arrange the data into horizontal rows. Horizontal rows and vertical columns. It's called as horizontal rows and vertical columns. It's called as tabulation. For that, you can write there. We process to arrange the data into vertical columns and horizontal rows. That's called as tabulation. So I hope there is again a difference between what is classification and what is tabulation, which is approximately same to each other. Now this is the part 5. Now move here part 6. Part 6 I will discuss about the discrete and continuous. Next one, class limits and class boundaries. Must also was which is very very beneficial to you. In solving problems, you already know that we face two types of data. One is discrete and second is continuous. First of all, I discuss about discrete. Discrete type of data is just like, you can write here 2 to 3, next 4 to 5, next 6 to 7. You can say that it has isolated figures. You can write here isolated figures. That type of data is called as discrete data. And continuous data shape of is just like of data is as 2 to 4. Next will be here 4 to 8. Repetition 8 to, you can say that 8 to next it will be 10. That's repetition, you can say that repetition or you can say that continuously. That type of data is a continuous, and that type of data is a discrete with phase in the problem. Next type is here, class limits and class boundaries. Very easy definition of telling you about what are class limits. You can write here limits of discrete groups. Are called as class limits. Must remember that limits of discrete groups are called as class limit. That's clear. Similarly, follow the step. Similarly, limits of continuous groups are called as class boundaries. So I hope that you gain a lot of points about that discrete, continuous, next class limits and class boundaries. That was the part 6. Now part 7. Part 7 is coming now, which contains midpoint, cumulative frequency and class interval, which is I'm giving lecture soon. Mean of upper limit and lower limit of each group is called as midpoint. Midpoint, what is the midpoint? You can see there, mean of upper limit and lower limit of each group, that's called as midpoint. Midpoint is also defined as class mark. And it is denoted by small x. That's your next point. Class interval. What is the class interval? Very simple definition. The difference between very easy definitions. The difference between upper class boundaries, and lower class boundaries of each group is called as class interval. It also can be said class width. Class interval, it also defined as class width. Simply, the difference between upper class boundary and lower class boundary, which we call as class interval. Last point is here, cumulative frequency. What is cumulative frequency? The frequency less than the upper class boundary of a group. upper class boundary of a group is called as cumulative frequency. I hope that you gain a lot of points about the clear points about midpoint, class interval, cumulative frequency, which is the part 7. Now, next part is the part 8. Part 8 lecture, I will discuss about the parts of table which are very, very beneficial to you. Must also watch. That's given here the parts of a table. Must remember that these column captions, this portion is called as box set of table, and the first of all, there is the title of that table which we write in that section. And stub, what is stub? These row captions, each row captions is called as stub, and body is the part of that table. And must remember that footnotes and source note always are below the table. I hope that you have gained a point. And last lecture is given here, which is the part 9 of the lecture. In this lecture, I will discuss about the pie diagram, pie chart, and last stem and leaf display, which is coming now. Pie diagram or pie chart has a shape of just like pizza. Must remember that pie diagram, pie chart has a shape of just like pizza. I make a shape just like that shape of pizza. That's called as pie diagram or pie chart. Last point is given here, stem and leaf display. What is that stem and leaf display? So must remember that stem and leaf display have two ways. It is, data can be converted into two ways. First way is very, very easy. In first way, we have, for example, we have number 1, 2, 3. For example, this number we divide into two sections. First step is there, leading digit number 1, leading digit and second is trailing digits. Trailing digits. In that section, we divide the data into that's 1 and that's we put here 2, 3. So that's 1 is the stem and that 2, 3 is the leaf. So that is called as stem and leaf display. And next, we'll take an example of second. In its same digit, we can write here leading digits and trailing digits. You can put here data in 1, 2 in first section. I can write here that section is 3. So theirs will be stem and their section will be leaf. So must remember that stem and leaf display divide data into two ways. You can write here 1, 2, 3. That should be stem, this leaf, that we want to combine as 3. I hope that you gain a lot of points about that. And also share that lecture with your class fellows and friends. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, then kindly must subscribe to my YouTube channel. And must press bell icon button for gaining notification of my new lecture. Goodbye.